If you know your subject, it will be very easy to treat the patient. So input will be care delivered by the provider. We are a healthcare provider. Again, second input will be the follow through by the patient, and that comes with the health longevity and quality of life. Similarly, in all kidney patients, if health provider knows their subject very well, and if patient itself, himself, will follow the order, then they will have a better quality of life to survive and to improve their quality of life for further their life to increase the longevity. So for any longevity, you must know your subject to treat the patient. Earlier, we used to tell it's a chronic renal failure and acute renal failure. Now this terminology has changed, and if anybody will write down an acute kidney injury, it's known as an acute renal failure. So previously it was known as an acute renal failure. The terminology has changed to acute kidney injury. In small, we say AKI. Similarly, a chronic renal failure has now been replaced by chronic kidney disease, because when we say chronic renal failure, when patient knows that it is a renal failure or a kidney failure, they get irritated, they get restless, ki apna to patta kat gaya abhi. So we always say chronic kidney disease as compared to the chronic renal failure. This terminology used now at a globe, everyone is using this terminology of chronic kidney disease. And communication with the patient is more meaningful and better understood, and that's why this terminology has changed from last few years to the chronic kidney disease. Now what do you mean by a chronic kidney disease? So it's characterized by decrease in glomerular filtration rate less than 60 per minute of 1.73 meter square area of the body with or without kidney damage. Now when I say with or without kidney damage, when I say without kidney damage means the glomeruli is still intact, they are still throwing the proper filtration but at the lower rate. There is no anatomical or structural damage has occurred during that time. And when I say with glomerular damage or with kidney damage, a structural changes has already started or histopathological changes has already been started. So histopathological evidence of reduction in nephron mass, when I say is with the kidney damage, so there is an histopathological evidence of reduction in nephrological population or nephron population, it's indicate it's a chronic kidney disease. This chronic, I don't know why this has happened, chronic kidney disease has a clinical course which a progressive, unrelenting loss of nephron function, which either goes to the ESRD, that is the end stage renal disease. However, there is a time lapse between the initial outset of the disease and the ESRD. Why I say time lapse between the initial outset of the disease and end stage renal disease? When in initial period of time, when patient comes to you with certain damage in the kidney, it takes 2 to 12 years, 2 to 15 years to go the patient to end stage renal disease or a dialysis. So time lapse of 10 years, 12 years, 2 years or 1 year is in hand of doctor and is hand of patient. If patient follows the proper order, proper advice, and if healthcare provider does a proper job of them, you can progress, you can allow patient to remain at a particular stage and increase the days or years for progression to the end stage renal disease. So we have enough time from early chronic kidney disease to end stage renal disease, or patient with the kidney disease to go on a dialysis. So what are the stages of chronic kidney disease? Now when I say chronic kidney disease, now it has been divided into 5 stages. There is a kidney damage with normal or increased glomerular filtration rate. Now you will tell me why you have to say no normal or increase. So initial period of diabetes, there is an hyperglycemia. With hyperglycemia at the glomerular level, and during that stage with an hyperglycemia at the glomeruli, there will be increase in the glomerular filtration rate. With that increase in the glomerular filtration rate, there is an endothelial damage at the glomeruli and they will start leaking the albumin. So with increase of the GFR also, you have a early kidney damage. And if GFR is more than 90 ml per minute per 0.173 square meter area. Mild reduce in GFR, that is 60 to 90, that is a stage number 2. Then there is a further decrease in a GFR will be between 30 to 59. Severe reduction in GFR between 15 to 29 and less than 50 is a kidney failure or end stage renal disease. When I say kidney failure, that is end stage renal disease, that is less than 15 and patient requires a dialysis during that time. So these are the 5 stages of kidney disease. So from stage 1 to stage 5, it takes 1 year, 2 year, 10 year to 12 year or more than 12 year also. Because if you tackle the patient at a GFR of 90 or a GFR of 60 to 90, you can treat them very well and you decline their further progression of end stage renal disease by giving proper medication. So again, there is another classification of CKD, and during this stage or a classification, you have a certain action plan what you can do it to prevent further progression of end stage renal disease. So if patient are a risk factor of CKD with the stage 1 or at increased risk when the GFR is more than 90, so now which are the population which are at the higher risk? Patient of diabetes, patient of blood pressure with a family history of kidney disease, or patient with a proteinuria, they are at a higher risk of a kidney damage, and during that time your action plan will be periodical test for the CKD, and that is urine routine, creatinine, etc. When there is a stage 1, that is a kidney damage with a normal or increased GFR or more than 90 or up to 90, you diagnose the type of kidney disease, treat comorbid condition like diabetes, blood pressure, any proteinuria, etc. And they are at a higher risk for cardiovascular damage, so treat for the cardiovascular problem. With a patient of kidney stage, CKD stage 2, you have to adjust the drug dosage depend upon the glomerular filtration rate. Between kidney stage 3, you have to evaluate for and treat the complication of CKD and avoid nephrotoxic drug, which we'll tell you later. And with a severe reduction, you prepare patient for a kidney replacement therapy, that is renal replacement therapy, that is preparation for dialysis or renal transplantation. And stage 5, they either go for dialysis or they have to go for a renal replacement, that is a transplantation. So if you know the classification, you know the GFR, you must know the what is the action plan during the management of the patient of CKD. So as a family physician or as a further homeopathic consultant, what will be your role in the prevention and management of CKD? So one has to recognize the pandemic of CKD, that is 10% of population is suffering from CKD. To know the new terminology and classification of CKD, to be aware that serum creatinine rises only after 50% of the kidney get damaged. Now everybody should know that when the creatinine comes to between 1.4 to 2, patient has already damaged their kidney by 50%. Okay, so you must aware when to get the serum creatinine done, and do not neglect a patient with a creatinine of 1.4, 1.5, 1.6, you must treat that patient and send it to nephrology or a consultant physician for further management. Identify population at risk, that is like diabetes, blood hypertension and chronic kidney disease with a family history of chronic kidney, and screening test for community. All the camps are going on. So this screening test for community, which will be, should be either urine for albumin, urine for microalbumin, albumin creatinine ratio and serum creatinine. Occasionally sonography of kidney, just to find out the screening test for community. If community at the certain village where they are having a well water, drinking well water, you must see them for the X-ray KUB and sonography to find out either they have a renal stone or not. So which are the population at high risk of CKD? So population at risk for a chronic kidney disease, before we will take this slide on, I'll just give certain examples.